Dear students, I am B.S. Nerd, a lecturer in English in Surat School, Mahendragarh. Dear students, today I am going to start a very important topic of 12th class CBSE, that's invitation writing. Invitation writing carries 3 marks according to the latest marking scheme of the CBSE for English in 12th class. So, dear students, invitations as you know that it is a kind of request or a message sent to our near and dears on the species occasion like birthday celebration, marriage ceremony, wedding anniversary, opening ceremony, inauguration ceremony, or the important programs which are conducted in a school like annual prize distribution function or any type of program which is held in a school, at our home, or anywhere else. So, dear students, invitations can be divided into two parts. I mean to say, invitations are of two types, formal invitations and informal invitations. And formal invitations further can be divided into two parts, formal written and formal printed. Formal printed, it means card-based, card formats. And formal written, it means letter writing. Yes, invitations are of two types, formal invitations and informal invitations. And formal invitations are of two types. First is known as printed invitations. They are based on card making, and the next one is handwritten. You can say letter format of writing invitations. So, today I am going to tell you important points while writing a card. It means printed invitations. So, what important points should be kept in mind while writing a formal invitation in the form of a printed one? So, first of all, dear students, it should be written in one single sentence. Printed invitations is always written in one single sentence. Different type of sentence are not adopted while writing an invitation, a card. So, dear students, there should be a single sentence from top to bottom. You will mention all the matter into a single sentence. And the next important point you will take in your minds is that mention name of the host in the beginning. Dear students, usually we see the invitation card. So, first of all, there is the name of the host. It means who is inviting the people, who is organizing a function, that is called the host. We write Mr. and Mrs. Anuj Prakash, request your benign presence. So, Mr. and Mrs. Prakash, or we can say that the principals, the staff and the students, these are known as the host. So, first of all, while writing a card, it means while writing a printed invitation, you will mention the name of the host in the beginning. Then, name of the invitee is not mentioned. Dear students, it is a very important point to be noted that name of the invitee, it means to whom we are inviting, that is not mentioned in such kind of invitations, because the host invites so many persons, so many people, so many VIPs. So, dear student, the name of the invitee is not mentioned in such kind of invitations. It is mentioned there when we write in letter format. But here, in the printed one, the name of the invitee is not mentioned at all. It is there on the envelope. Mention standard expression. When we start such kind of invitation, first of all, I have already told you that you will mention the name of the host, and after that you will mention standard expression like Mr. and Mrs. Anuj Prakash, request your benign presence on the auspicious occasion of the marriage of their daughter. So, mention standard expression. You can also write that Mr. and Mrs. Anuj Prakash, request your pleasure on the benign presence, and you can write Mr. and Mrs. Anuj Prakash, solicit your gracious presence You can, I will tell you later, the matter should be centralized in case of card. Dear students, the matter should be centralized. It should be there in the center of your answer sheets. It should not be left hand side or the right hand side. It should be there in the middle of the page. I mean to say, all the material should be centralized in case of card, in case of printed invitations. After that, it should be written in simple present tense. Simple present tense is used while writing such kind of invitations. Only simple present tense. And after that, it should be written in third person pronoun. First person and second person pronoun are never used while drafting such kind of invitation. I mean, I invite you, we invite you, no. Mr. and Mrs. R.K. Sharma invite you on the auspicious occasion of the marriage of their daughter or son. So, the third person pronoun are always used. Springly, we can use the second person pronoun. And while writing the invitation in letter format, at that time we are free to use the second or third person pronoun. But dear students, here you will not use second or third person pronoun. Next one, mention the name of special guest to whom you are inviting on that occasion. So you will mention the name of VIP, special guest or the program. The name of the special guest is there, which type of program there in the school. But in case of wedding ceremony, in the case of marriage, you will mention the program only. There is no special guest in invitation card for marriage. There is only program like arrival of the barat, departure of the barat, reception of the barat. Dear students, mention date, time and venue. It is very important part of a invitation. You must mention when the program will be organized, where it will be organized and what is the specific time for it. And next one, RSVP. It is a French phrase which means respond, s'il vous plaît. It means respond if you please. And then highlight the important information. Dear student, when I will tell you in my next video, when you write the important points like the name of the school, the name of the chief guest, the name of the host, all these things are written prominently in block letters. It should be written in capital form, I mean to say. Capital letters. Highlight the important information. I have just told you that you should highlight the name of the host, name of the school, name of the chief guest. It should be enclosed in a box. At last, you will put all the material in a box. Don't forget to put all the things in a box. And after that, you will mention the name of the host, or you can write address and phone number left hand side of the invitation. Don't forget to write the address and phone number of the host. And dear student, this is all to be taken into your mind while writing a card for invitation. That is called invitation card. And so, marking scheme, dear students, you know very well that what's the marking scheme for invitation in 12th class. Dear student, one mark is reserved for format. Second, one mark is reserved for content. And the last one is reserved for accuracy or expression. In this type, it carries, invitation writing carries 3 marks. 1 mark for format, 1 mark for grammatical accuracy, and 1 mark is reserved for contents. So this is all for today. Thanks and have a nice day. Thanks all of you.